when I was 9, living in Los Angeles. I knew nothing about classical music. My family was completely unmusical. It was raining and we couldn't go out and play in the yard in our elementary school, and they took us into the auditorium during lunch and they showed us, just to keep us quiet, they showed us a movie of a Leonard Bernstein Young Person's Concert in Carnegie Hall. And on that concert, Bernstein was conducting Shostakovich's first symphony, and he turned to the children in the audience and he said, "Now children, Dmitri Shostakovich wrote this piece when he was 19 years old and became world famous overnight. And I remember thinking, I have 10 years. And after that, I became a composer. So I feel like, you know, Carnegie Hall has been with me as long as I knew, you know, what music was. I started borrowing instruments from friends who knew stuff, and I would just borrow a trumpet, and I would make a couple noises on the trumpet, and then I would invent a little squiggle system to notate it. I didn't know how to write anything. I didn't know how to do anything. My father had just a couple of classical records. One of them was Beethoven violin sonatas with David Oistrakh and Sviatoslav Richter. So I borrowed a trombone from somebody down the street, and I made a little piece of music with little squiggles telling me what to do, where I could play a trio with my friends David Oistrakh and Sviatoslav Richter. So I'd come home from school, I'd put on this record, so I'd written a little part for myself to play along with them. So that was my first piece. And very quickly, I just started writing things that I thought were music. I started buying records, listening to music, going to concerts. I was very acquisitive about anything having to do with classical music. And by the time I was 13, my mother took me to UCLA, to the composition department there. And she took me to this really interesting composer, Henri Lazaroff, who at the time was the head of the department. And she showed him these hundreds of ridiculous, completely unheard juvenile, you know, scratchings. And he looked at them and he asked if I would be interested in studying with him. So I studied with this man for 2 days a week until I went to college. And that's basically where I learned how to write music. I think usually composers start because they play an instrument and they fall in love with sound and they think, I'm playing this music by these old dead people, you know, how come it's not happening for me? You know, how come I'm not doing it? For me, it was completely the opposite. I became a composer groupie at the beginning and I wasn't really interested in being a player. So I don't actually play any instrument very well. And so for me, all of my knowledge of music, of any kind of music, Western music, pop music, world music, whatever, it's all completely from the composer's point of view. How did a decision get made by somebody or some group of people that created this sound? I only know all of music from the composer's side. So I do think it's kind of an unusual place to have begun.